as you mentioned, a lot of changes already taking place here at the Jacob Javits Playground. This park, this playground has been closed since yesterday, and we're expecting all playgrounds to be closed by tomorrow. I can tell you we've already seen parks enforcement driving around, making sure there aren't people inside this, as we're starting to hear from the front lines, the people working inside those hospitals trying to save lives.
It's behind those big goggles. Most of us are fighting back our tears while fighting the disease.
An ER doctor sharing her experience as she tries to save lives. She's served in the Iraq War. Fighting the coronavirus in a New York City hospital is heart-wrenching.
I don't think I was emotionally prepared to witness this in the U.S., like for when going to a war zone.
The war zone is New York. Hospitals across the city considered the front lines. Today, a 68-bed field hospital in Central Park started treating patients, providing some relief for Mount Sinai across the street. The state seeing nearly 400 deaths in the last 24 hours. The governor believes the peak of the outbreak to hit at the end of the month. In order to prevent more cases, the governor getting more aggressive, today announcing he will shut down city playgrounds just as spring begins.
I warned people that if they didn't stop the density and the games in the playgrounds, you can't play basketball. You can't come in contact with each other.
Outside several city hospitals, makeshift morgues set up. As the cases and deaths surge, hospitals are working with the medical examiner, setting these trailers up. Patients who die can't spend their final moments with loved ones for fear the virus will spread to them too.
Well, some of the difficulty is actually not allowing family members to be with their loved ones when they die. And having to tell them that they can't do that is just one of, for me, emotionally a very difficult process.
We are confident, based on all our projections, that for next week we will have sufficient eye protection. That means the face shields and the goggles, and sufficient surgical gloves for all those needs for everyone who's doing this crucial work, for all our heroes who are out there protecting us.
In that news conference just moments ago, the mayor said there is still a need for ventilators, there is still a need for masks, those surgical masks and the N95 masks. He's hoping to get them as soon as possible because the front lines, the hospitals, need it. We're live in Inwood this afternoon. I'm Ray Vieda, News 4 New York.